Everyone, welcome to another episode of Content and Links. Today, we're going to talk about how to use Google Images to actually rank better in the normal results. So something I realized recently in looking at a lot of the Google image results is they actually can tell you the kind of things that users want in typical results and allow you to rank better there. And if anything else, also give you little hints to drive more long-tail traffic to your posts overall. So first example of this is say we pull up the search startup statistics and then click the images tab. We look at the kind of images we see there. What we actually pick up are a lot of graphs and just vertical graphs, bar charts, et cetera. And this is actually a clear hint, the kind of things people want to see when they actually search these searches. An example of what you could do instead for these kind of things is just like a simple statistic visualized with an icon or something like that. And that might work and you might occasionally rank well, but it's not actually what users want for that based on image searches. We are making some assumptions here, but it's a reasonable belief that Google might re-rank these searches based on click-through rate. So if someone is more likely to click an image, they'll naturally re-rank those over time. Of course, there will be some image optimization thrown in there as well, but this is giving us a hint about what people want. And by nature, if we get some any early indication of what people want based on what they click, we're getting some hints of what we should also put in our blog post, because this is a user experience signal we're basically picking up based on what the Google image tab says. So if I'm building a post on startup statistics, I want to make sure I'm using a bar chart to kind of visualize this data. So maybe it's the number of startups in each country, et cetera, et cetera. You can see this firstsiteguide.com is actually visualized a ton of those resources in that way. And they're effectively dominating this search result, I think partially because of how they're visualizing that data. And also possible as a co-occurrence kind of thing that Google is looking for this kind of data visualization to actually highlight statistics overall as compared to alternatives. Other examples of this are, say, the search, how to tie a tie. And if you pull up these images, you might think maybe it just is an image of a tie or something like that would be a decent visual to show on your post. That would be incorrect. To actually be what users want for this search, you can see it's actually a step-by-step illustration of the different visualizations of how a tie should look at each step. So on our actual Google search result, should we want to rank better, we should also have a visualization that looks like this. Of course, considering things like how do we differentiate, how do we improve on these things, et cetera. I think you can take this a step further by considering what this search result looks like and also the image tab to think about how you can stand out should your images be shown there. So some examples of this I've seen on maybe basic PDFs are actually just they'll want a form, and every form is just a boring looking image, but you could have a red border around your form and that would draw the eye and make you want to click as a user. So one other example of this in action, say coronavirus statistics is another term you might want to rank for. If you look at this, it's actually a lot of charts of growth in case counts over time and that time chart that we unfortunately have probably all seen several times now. But if you created a post on statistics for coronavirus, you want to be very relevant and actually what users want to see, which is that time chart hopefully showing a decline in those case counts if you didn't include that. So we're getting hints immediately based on what is being shown in this section of what users want, which is that time chart of case count, growth and decline over time. So if we want to rank in the regular results, we would need to do those same things. So the overall takeaway here is just to look, no matter what search result you're on, even if it's not clearly saying it needs images based on the all section showing images, you can still learn something from that area. Of course, use some caution. There are stock photos that might show up on some search results. It doesn't mean it shows boring looking stock photo just because they're there. Use a discerning understanding of how someone might interact. But overall, if you're searching for something, that indication of the top bar of what's being highlighted, like news, videos, books, images, et cetera, if images is one of those top few in that list, that's showing that users really do want images on that result. And even if they're not being shown on the search result directly, they might occasionally click there and give you some hints about how to build a better user experience to rank overall. So I hope this was valuable for you in ranking better in the search results. If you like this, please jam the subscribe button, hammer that notification bell, give us a like, a thumbs up, and let us know what you thought in the comments. And thanks for watching.